25% of all countries in the world are small island nations. Most of them face a shortage of freshwater resources. Europe's tourist hotspot, Malta, is one such water-stressed island nation. The country has no perennial rivers or streams. Thus, Malta is highly dependent on seawater to produce their drinkable water via four different desalination plants. Potable water in Malta is a blend of 60% of desalinated water and 40% groundwater. Today, their groundwater is a resource in dire need of rescue measures.
Both the island of Malta and the island of Gozo are nitrates vulnerable zone. The European Union has established the levels, which is of 50 milligrams per liter. In terms of nitrates level in our groundwater, we've got areas where the nitrates content is up to 200 milligrams per liter.
The quality of potable water on the island is currently good. Nitrate levels in the groundwater are monitored by one control station per 7 square kilometers. In the past, the use of fertilizers and manure in farming and former illegal abstraction of groundwater have been key sources of nitrate contamination. Today, manure from livestock can only be applied on farmlands between mid-March and mid-October. Maltese farmers rely on imported mineral fertilizer, thus opting for a non-renewable resource.
What we have is the Nitrates Directive. It is important that everyone adheres to it. We cannot spread excessive fertilizer, so that this does not go down in the water table. And also because this has become very expensive. It's not cheap, and therefore you have to pay attention how much you use.
What if Malta could produce its own fertilizer, which is also free of contaminants? This land with its small-scale farming would benefit from biogas plants if there was a way to collect and process the digested waste. Hope is seen in the form of the European research project NOMAD, where a pilot lab on wheels is equipped with the technology to process digested sludge and enable fertilizer production from its solid residue.
Unlike other places where the NOMAD truck was being tested, here we are talking about sludge, that is the solid part coming from the sewage treatment. And instead of actually disposing it in landfills or wherever, we can use that sludge to have something out of it.
The household wastewater of 500,000 residents is treated at the largest sewage treatment plant on the island, Tabarkat. It is the chosen demo site for the NOMAD project. First, the sewage arrives at the furthest part of the plant. From here, it is pumped uphill to be treated via a flocculation process, where the solid and liquid parts are separated. The solid part is directed into the two anaerobic digesters to produce energy.
The NOMAD truck sits right next to the anaerobic digesters and it will receive into it the digested directly, which is then treated through the processes built on the truck itself.
Digestate, the residual waste after biogas production, consists of both solid and liquid components. The solid component could be used as a natural fertilizer after undergoing the antibiotic removal and nitrate removal processes, whereas the liquid treated fraction can be used in industry and agriculture for cleaning and irrigational purposes.
The reason why we went for this project and why we said, yes, this makes a lot of sense for the Maltese islands, which in total they are around 325 kilometers squared. It's exactly that. If you have a mobile truck which is collecting digestate from different plants, treating it, even if treating it at a central location, and then facilitating the treatment of the digest and then disseminating it again, yes, it would help because of issues related to economies of scale.
The farmers on the island are ever ready to reduce groundwater usage and ready to opt for treated wastewater. The NOMAD truck could prove to be of help here. Currently, treated sewage water is supplied to many farms by the Water Services Corporation.
In this particular area,
The water that we get from the boreholes comes up from a depth of at least 600 feet, and thus we need to use lots of electricity. Therefore, if we use this treated water, we will reduce our expenses and obviously also less use of electricity in the country. I know farmers who are using this treated water coming from the drainage, and their products are nice, good to eat. Have a long shelf life too, like the other products.
Our fields, as you can see all around you, these fields are quite small by European standards. Malta is a very highly densely populated island. There's a high competition for land, which is increasing the cost of land, and by definition, it's increasing the cost of production.
For over 500 years, Malta has depended heavily on imports for fulfilling the local demand. If the NOMAD project were to be successful, it would encourage larger-scale farmers to install anaerobic digestion plants to produce energy and create their own fertilizer, from which they could use the liquid fraction for irrigation.
The use of the NOMAD truck will actually allow for less use of artificial fertilizers, and that would mean that in our groundwater we will have less nitrates being present. So that will directly reflect in our potable water production.